911, what's your emergency?
I just had an allergic reaction to my bug spray. So that didn't actually happen. I didn't call 911 because I was in Ghana, Africa. But I did really have an allergic reaction to my bug spray halfway across the world. So, story time.
We are no longer in Kansas. We are in Ghana, in West Africa.
So, you know, while I was preparing for Africa, I was like, you know, I really need a good mosquito repellent. So I did my digging on Amazon. I made sure the thing had, you know, great reviews. I read up on the reviews. Seems like everybody loved it. It worked miracles for them while they were, you know, wherever they were traveling to. And I was like, all right, I placed the order. I was ready. I felt set. I felt, you know, like I could take on the world of this bug spray. Little did I know what was to come. So we flew from Miami to New York and then from New York to Accra, Ghana. And, you know, right when we land, you know, they're like, all right, guys, you know, you might want to, you know, get ready, get your bug spray out, yada, yada, yada. And me, I'm like, all right, I got my bug spray. I'm ready to go. When I'm telling you, like, people are turning heads when I walk by, like, it's really strong. But I'm like, you know what? It has to be potent. It has to be really working if it's that strong. So we're in Ghana. And fast forward to that night, you know, they were like, all right, guys, like, lights out, lights out. And I don't know why I thought I should put on my bug spray when I went to sleep. But something was like,
yeah, you know, you might want to put it on. That way when you're sleeping, you don't get bit.
One eternity later.
It's like 2:30 in the morning. And I just turn on all the lights. And I just start like digging through my bag, looking for something that might like soothe the itching or something. And my roommate gets up and starts looking for stuff with me. Like, bruh, when I tell you that cemented our friendship. Like, we just started looking through our bags, just tearing stuff apart, looking for either a aloe or a lotion or some type of cream. And finally, my dog looked like he had something in his bag. It was an aloe vera gel. And that thing worked magic. That thing, like, saved my entire night because I was like, I felt like it was the end of the world. I felt like that pain could, like, not go away. So having that little incident occur taught me a couple things. One, it taught me to be more independent. I already consider myself independent, but, you know, like, having that situation break out, like, in the middle of the night, the first thing I thought of was, like, oh, my God, like, I gotta let my parents know. But I'm all the way in Ghana. They can't do anything for me. So it just really, like, forced me to just, all right, you gotta get up. You better start looking for something to see if it would help you out. Two, you know, it's okay to be vulnerable. And, you know, like, me being in a vulnerable state, you know, like, I was in so much agony. You know, it's okay to be vulnerable. It's okay to show how you're feeling. It's okay to accept help from others. Finally, bonding with others. You know, like, you can bond with people at the weirdest times. Like, that experience right there, like, cemented our friendship right there. So if you enjoyed this video, drop me a like. I greatly appreciate it. If you want to see more content like this, drop me a comment down below so I can see what ideas you guys have. Don't forget to like this video, share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can stay tuned for my next video. And I'll see you guys next time.